Filmora Pro Video Editor. Advanced editing, effects, and motion graphics made easy. This series of tutorials are going to teach you how to edit in Filmora Pro, from start to finish. Hi everyone, my name is Johnny, and in this tutorial we'll be learning about Filmora Pro's project settings. We'll get familiar with templates, timecode, resolution, frame rate, and audio. These are some technical settings that we need to be aware of when we work with media files, and in this video we will discuss what they are and how they affect your video projects. There are three ways to create a new project in Filmora Pro. We can click on the Create New Project option on the home screen. We can go to the toolbar and click on File New. Or we can just press the shortcut control of Control N on Windows or Command N on Mac. If we create a new project while already working on a project, we'll be asked if we want to save the current project before Filmora Pro creates a new one. When we create a new project, we'll be directed to the Edit screen. One of the first things we should do is to go to our project settings by clicking on the toolbar on File Project Settings. Here we can choose the settings for our edit. Depending on what kind of project you're working on, you may want to choose different settings for your edit. For example, a video meant for Instagram would likely have a different resolution setting than a video meant for 4K TV. We have two tabs to choose from at the top of this window, Editor and Rendering. Let's start with the first tab. Here we can choose between templates. These are pre-made combinations of settings for different uses. In most cases, all you'll need for a project is to choose from one of these presets, but today we'll go into all of the settings too. We can choose the duration of our project, which is set to 5 minutes by default. As you can see, the timecode format for most video editing software is set in four groups of two-digit numbers each. From left to right, the first number is hours, then we have minutes, followed by seconds, and finally our last value on the right is frames. So, as an example, if we want to make a project 0 hours, 15 minutes, and 30 seconds long, this is the timecode we would want to use. The resolution of our project is measured in how many pixels wide and how many pixels tall that it is. By default, Filmora Pro projects will start with a resolution of 1920 pixels wide by 1080 pixels high, since this is the scale of a standard full HD video. We can freely change the resolution by modifying the number on each box. If we want to change the width scale, the height scale will automatically change to preserve the aspect ratio. If we want to freely modify the proportions of our video, we can turn off Preserve Aspect Ratio by clicking this chain icon here. Now that we're free to choose whichever resolution we want, we can create a vertical video from a smartphone or a square video for Instagram. When watching video, we're not looking at moving objects, but rather a sequence of images or frames being shown in sequence at a certain rate, which our brains then interpret into emotion. The frame rate is a number of frames a video will show within a second. Many digital video cameras shoot at 23.976 and 29.97 frames per second, which are the standards in countries that use the NTSC system. 25 and 50 frames per second are used by cameras in countries that use the PAL system. Most movies work in 24 frames per second. Some TV shows and home cameras work in 30 frames per second, which reflects a realistic motion, similar to what we are used to seeing in real life. Anything higher than 30 frames per second is mainly used to create slow motion, though some people, primarily gamers, tend to work with higher frame rates, like 60 frames per second. If you are making videos to post on social media or YouTube, most frame rates should work just fine, but it's ideal to match the settings of whatever footage your camera took. By default, Filmora Pro will ask you if you want to match the settings of your footage when you drag your first clip into the editor from the media panel. We can also change the pixel aspect ratio, but in most cases we'll just want to use the default square pixels option. The sample rate is the number of samples of audio carried per second, measured in hertz. The higher the sample rate, the better the audio quality. 48,000 Hz is the standard rate, commonly used for video, but if you're set on changing it, you could change it here. If we have a specific arrangement of settings that are not already available in the templates, we can create and save our own template. For example, let's say we want to make several vertical full HD videos at 24 frames per second for social media. To create this template, we will deactivate the preserve aspect ratio option by clicking this chain icon here. Change the resolution to 1080p wide and 1920p high. Change the frame rate to 24 frames per second. Click on the Save Settings as a Template option, and write the name of our new template. In this example, we'll choose Vertical Full HD Format. Hit the Enter key, and now every time we want to use this format, we can just choose it from our templates. The Rendering tab will let us change some advanced settings for color and anti-aliasing, but we will get deeper into this in future tutorials. After choosing our settings, we can hit the OK button and then we are ready to go. So that's a look at starting your project in Filmora Pro. To learn more about editing in Filmora Pro, make sure to check out our other tutorials in this series. There's no limit to what you can make.